Biodiversity and Conservation Part 4. So in this video we will learn why do we need to conserve biodiversity. Why do we need to conserve the biodiversity? We need to conserve biodiversity on the following grounds, like narrow utilitarian values, broadly utilitarian values, and ethical values. Narrow utilitarian value: humans derive countless economic benefits from nature, like food, like in the form of cereals, pulses, fruits, firewood, fiber, construction materials, industrial products like tannin, lubricants, dyes, resins, perfumes, and many plants of medicinal value. With increasing resources put into bioprospecting, nations endowed with rich biodiversity can expect to reap enormous benefits. Broadly utilitarian values: biodiversity plays a major role in many ecosystem services that nature provides free of cost. And the services include like preservation of environment, regulation of the climate, absorption and degradation of pollutants, maintaining gaseous composition, formation of soil, maintenance of water cycle, pollination, flood and erosion control, nutrient cycling, microbial waste treatment, and biological pest control. Ethical reasons: all organisms have a role to play, and hence conserving them is of utmost importance, and we have to leave the biological legacy for the future generations too. Now let us look at the ways to conserve. There are two broad ways. One is in situ conservation, other is ex situ conservation. In situ conservation of biodiversity is the conservation of species within their natural habitat. In this method, the natural ecosystem is maintained and protected. In situ conservation has several advantages, like it's a cost effective and convenient method of conserving biodiversity. A large number of living organisms can be conserved simultaneously. And since the organisms are in a natural ecosystem, they can evolve better and can easily adjust to different environmental conditions. Certain protected areas where in situ conservation takes place include national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, and biosphere reserves. Now, national parks. There are several small reserves maintained by the government. Its boundaries are well demarcated, and human activities such as grazing, forestry, habitat and cultivation are prohibited. Example: Kanha National Park, Bandipur National Park. Wildlife sanctuaries are the regions where only wild animals are found. Human activities such as timber harvesting, cultivation, collection of woods and other forest products are allowed here, as long as they do not interfere with the conservation projects. Also, tourists visit these places of recreation. Biosphere reserves are multipurpose protected areas where the wildlife, traditional lifestyle of the inhabitants, and domesticated plants and animals are protected. Tourist and research activities are permitted here. Look at ex situ conservation. It is the conservation of biodiversity involves breeding and maintenance of endangered species in artificial ecosystems such as zoos, nurseries, botanical gardens, gene banks, etc. There is less competition for food, water, and space among the organisms. And the advantages of ex situ conservation are: animals are provided with a longer time and breeding activity, species bred in captivity can be reintroduced into the wild, and genetic techniques can be used for the preservation of endangered species. Now, what are the strategies for biodiversity conservation? So we had to look into that what are the different ways we can save the species that are becoming extinct due to our own activities. Now, the following strategies would really help in conserving biodiversity, like all varieties of food, timber, plants, livestock, microbes, and agricultural animals should be conserved. All the economically important organisms should be identified and conserved. Unique ecosystems should be preserved first. Resources should be utilized efficiently. Poaching and hunting of wild animals should be strictly prevented, and it should be punishable if violated. The reserves and protected areas should be developed carefully. The level of pollutants should be reduced in the environment, and deforestation should be reduced, should be strictly prohibited. Not reduced, it should be strictly prohibited. Environmental laws should be followed strictly. Useful and endangered species of plants and animals should be conserved in their nature as well as in the artificial habitats. And there should be an increased public awareness regarding biodiversity conservation and its importance.